Hi Ron, welcome back to another video of mine. And today we have yet another news video. This is, if I'm not mistaken, is my fourth or fifth video. So yeah, there are not much news last month, but just this month itself, this whole week have been really busy from Tapan. And then yeah, I think mostly from Tapan, there are no other news from other brands, especially Dragon Momoko. Surprisingly, after they announced the blue frame, there's no news at all or updates about it. So yeah, I think I'm pretty lucky that I did not pre-order the blue frame. But still, we don't know what are they doing. We just have to wait until they have officially released the blue frame. So yeah, without further ado, now today's news, we have total of three parts. The first part, I will be covering the figure news. Secondly, I will be covering Gunpla news. So yeah, basically there's two parts to it. So yep, without further ado, now let's start with our figure news. So this year, the figure news would be the Banpresto. They've just had the competition. The team is called World Colosseum, where there are multiple of many other different countries sculptors, where they send in their sketches on the figure that they plan to produce. So out of there, they chose the final five or six. Then out of there, they will choose one champion. So I will tell you which one is the champion as I move on. There are a total of two anime lines, which is Dragon Ball as well as the One Piece. So yeah, we start off first with Dragon Ball. So our first figure here, we have this Son Goku in Kamehameha form. So yeah, just very simple. Now we'll take a look at the next figure. Our next figure here, we have this Perfect Cell. Based on the sketch of it when they submitted it to sort of like a preview for us before they made it into a figure, I was actually really looking forward for this Cell figure, but not sure why the end product become like that. I'm not sure, is it the quality or I'm just really not sure. It looks very jumbled up, you know, like very crumpled on his chest. And I really don't know. I think maybe it's just the material, or I really don't know. Just yeah, looks weird. So next here we have this Frieza. So yeah, I think this actually looks quite good, but maybe just his tie there looks a little bit deformed. But yeah, to all of you guys who is a Frieza fan, you guys can consider this figure. And I think this figure is actually slightly bigger than the rest. So yeah, you guys can consider this Frieza. And of course, our last Dragon Ball piece here, we have this Trunks figure. Again, this Trunks figure looks great, so yeah, really happy for it. And this is actually the figure that won the overall prize for it. So yeah, that's really it for these Dragon Ball figures. And if I'm not mistaken, there is a couple of more, but these are the figures that is competed in the competition and is now already open for pre-orders. So yeah, you guys can pre-order if you want. And there is actually one or two more figures. There's one also Trunks shouting, which looks very deformed. And there's one Son Goku in the Sun Wukong or the Monkey King suit. So yeah, that figure is not out yet, so I can't show you guys. But once it's out again, I will show you guys in another, I guess, news video. So yeah, Dragon Ball figures, the competition of the World Colosseum is done. Now we'll move on to the One Piece. So our very first One Piece, the World Colosseum competition figure, we have this Shanks figure. And by the way, it looks really great. But of course, there is one more that looks much better than that. That's why it won the competition. I'm not sure if I would be getting the Shanks, but I would. If I can get a job within this year, then yeah, I'll pre-order that, and of course I'll review for you guys. And if you guys love Shanks as well as many people, so yeah, you guys can consider this Shanks. So yeah, next, let's move on. So next year we have this Mihawk figure. Again, looks great. I think the sword can be slightly bigger. So I think yeah, slightly bigger, it will look much better, but still it looks great. And of course, there are not much Mihawk figure out in the market. Usually, if there is, it's just him sitting down without his sword. But this is like Mihawk actually in action, the pose. So yeah, again, if you guys are fans of Shichibukai of Mihawk, you guys can consider this as well. And next year, of course, we have this Luffy figure where he's like floating, ready to pounce on and beat the crap out of Doflamingo. However, I mean, this figure, based on in front of us now, it looks quite weird. I would rather they show us this Luffy figure on the side way, like maybe just slant side a bit to show his side view, because at the front it looks kind of weird and deformed in a way. So yeah, I think I might skip on this Luffy figure instead, but still looks great. So yeah, next we move on to the next figure. So of course now we have another Zoro figure, and this is the figure that won the whole World Colosseum Banpresto One Piece figurine competition. So yeah, it beats Shanks, so you guys can see the detail of it, especially the sculpt on his shirt, like he's floating. So yeah, I think I might consider Zoro and Shanks figure, and maybe if I have extra cash then I would consider Mihawk. But yeah, and again there is a couple more. I remembered I saw a couple more of the figure as well. It was I'm not sure, I think it was Nami and Robin or Boa Hancock, the three female characters, either one of them, they were in the competition as well. But I don't know why they never show it. But yeah, that's it. This is the conclusion of all the One Piece figure Colosseum, the competition figure. As I always say that, I think in terms of figurine looks, although they always produce Dragon Ball figures, but I think they should now focus more on One Piece, because I think the sculptors for One Piece figurine actually looks really, really, really great. Like you can see all the details here. So yeah, that's it now for the World Colosseum. I still have a couple more figures that was announced this year. So yeah, it will be released in March or April, around there. So you guys can pre-order once I show you guys the figures that I will be showing later on. So yeah, without further ado, let's go. So again, there is no One Piece Banpresto news when this was actually in the one of the events that, but they only show Dragon Ball figures from one page that I follow on Facebook. There's no like One Piece news, so that's kind of sad. But nonetheless, still Dragon Ball figure looks great, part of our childhood, so we still look at it. So in front of us here, we have this Dragon, this Son Goku, that's with his cloak. At first, I thought it was Gohan, but there was actually another picture after that shows on the sideway that it is actually Goku. So yeah, now you have our very first announced figure. Next stop here, of course, we have our very first Goku, where he got the cloak from the hermit, the guy, the pervert old guy, after he saved the turtle. So yeah, this him is the cloak, and at the behind him, I'm not sure you guys can really see the picture, but Goku in his blue color uniform. So yeah, they come in two variant, as Banpresto always most of the time comes with that. So yep, second figure is done. Now let's move on to the third one. Next stop here, we have this Super Saiyan 3 Bardock figure. To be very honest, I do not know much about Bardock. I only know that he is Goku's father. So yeah, I think I should brush up on my Dragon Ball knowledge. But again, this looks really savage because just in front of you. However, the past releases of Super Saiyan 3 by Banpresto, it's actually not that great, to say the least. Let's hope that this figure will look great. However, again, I don't think I will be getting this Bardock Super Saiyan 3, because there are other figures that I've already pre-ordered when I'm going to show you after this. Next year, we have this Vegito figure. You guys can see it in Super Saiyan form. And I can tell you, this is definitely one of my wish lists. It's not out yet for pre-order, so I don't know when will it be available for me to pre-order. But once it is made available, I will definitely pre-order, because I mean, who doesn't love Super Saiyan form? Bardock Super Saiyan 3 looks savage, but sometimes it just doesn't look great. But this itself looks great, this Vegito Super Saiyan. So yeah, now let's move on to another figure. So here we have another Ichiban Kuji. This, it says Uyue, which means in May it will be released. I'm not sure this will be a normal release or it will be sort of like Japan price figure. So yeah, we still don't have the news for this. Let's hope that it will be a normal release, because again, I will be getting this, because you can see it's quite rare to find like Goku, this figure, being shouting like that. because others usually their hand is straight rather than hold up. So yeah, I think this looks much more proportioned. So yeah, now let's move on to another figure. So of course this is the Black Goku, the in normal Super Saiyan, I forgot what is it, but yeah, this Black Goku. Again, this is in Ichiban Kuji, same as the picture, the figure that I showed in the previous picture. I'm not sure again if this will be a release, normal release, or it will be the special price release, which is a little bit more expensive than normal Barbaresto release. So yeah, let's again hope it's normal release, because I personally think Black Goku looks really cool. So yeah, now this is done, let's move on to another announcement. So our next picture here is the Grandista resolution of Soldier, Goku in his normal form. I would say this is almost the same as if you guys have not watched my Grandista resolution of Soldier Super Saiyan 1 Goku, the very first release, I recommend you guys go and watch, because that figure is really awesome and really worth the price. And this is basically just Goku in Super Saiyan, this is just Goku in his normal form, and it's just facing the opposite side of the Super Saiyan 1, the Grandista resolution of Soldiers. So yeah, again, if this figure is once announced available for pre-order, I would definitely buy it, because it really is worth the price given the amount of details for it. So yeah, next we move on to our last figure announcement. So our last figure announcement is of course another Grandista resolution of Soldiers. This is Bardock of it, and in just like normal Super Saiyan form. It's just in his normal human form. So yeah, again, you can see the amount of details in it looks great as well. Again, I will pre-order this line. As long as it is under Grandista resolution of Soldiers, I would just recommend you guys just go and pre-order. You would be very satisfied with it, like I am. If you are of course a huge Bardock fan, again, just go and pre-order this figure, because it's huge, it's detailed, and it's quite heavy, and again, it's really value for money. Like, very hard to find this figure if next time you want to find it. So I recommend you guys don't vary, just go and buy it. So yeah, now all the figures news is done. We'll now move on to all the mobile suit or Gunpla, Metal Build, whatever news that will be coming up. So like I mentioned, our very first Gunpla news that was announced last month actually, this is the Metal Build Red Frame Astray Gundam. This is by a new company, I've not heard of it. Yeah, so to me it's new. It's called Fire Dragon. This is if I'm not mistaken, I read the description by the seller. Is they're made from diecast. So yeah, anyway, this is the front box art. If I'm not mistaken as well, it's the very same box art as the Bandai's Astray Red Frame Metal Build. So yeah, now we take a look at the back of the box art. Okay, so I think this actually is the front of the box art. I got mistaken, I guess, because I never have a Metal Build in my life before, so I don't know how is it. But either way, front or back, this is how it looks like, and looks great. It shows a very professional presentation, but I think it looks kind of much messy. I think they can do a much better work to present the red frame. So yeah, again, I have more pictures coming out on the red frame, so stay tuned. So I have multiple pictures to show you guys the completed Fire Dragon's Red Frame Astray Metal Build version. So yeah, you guys can just see as I talk along. So this company, yeah, like I say, just released their very first figure, and previously there are multiple of China company as well that released the 00 Riser, basically Axia Focus, but then now that this is a new company that focuses on red frame, I would guess. So yeah, I'm not sure how the quality is, but of course I will be probably planning to get a China Metal Build version just to try and get a feel of how is their quality. And of course it will be my first one that I can show you guys the review, whether is it worth your money or not, because this now available for pre-order in my country is 400 ringgit, which equivalent to, I would say, maybe RX 78 to perfect grade, around there, more or less around there, or I would say two, or how much would that be? I would say maybe two of the Hyakushiki, maybe two Hyakushiki 2.0, maybe slightly cheaper, just a little bit, but it's equivalent to two of that. So yeah, again, it's not cheap, because for 400 ringgit you can buy at least minimum three master grades already. So yeah, and this is of course not original Bandai, so don't know how is it. But anyway, you guys can see based on the pictures, it looks great. It has a very good, yes, show all the things that we need, like the articulation, the pose that we usually want the red frame to be able to do, and it is able to do so. So yeah, basically, this is just the news, our very first metal build Gunpla by Fire Dragon Company. Again, not sure how it is, so yeah, stay tuned to that. So now we move on to our very final news. This is by Tapan. So far, they've announced a total of 4 figures. I say announced, but there are actually 2 that is already either it's already out or it's on the way out. So yeah, our very first one, it's of course this Master Grade Freedom 2.0. This of course released by Bandai itself. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get this, because this is the Bandai Master Grade Freedom 2.0 is still within my price range. So most probably I wouldn't get it unless if my supplier gonna sell it on a clearance price, maybe really really dirt cheap, then maybe yeah, I will buy this and then make a comparison with the Bandai Freedom 2.0. So yeah, here are just a few couple of pictures that have been going through the background as I talk. Next, we'll move on to the second news that was announced. So the second news as well that was announced is this Master Grade RX 782 3.0. This was announced, I think if I'm not mistaken, is last month, but then they did not show much information about it, but it's really on the way out as I'm speaking right now. Again, the Master Grade Gunpla RX 782, Gundam RX 782 3.0 is within my price range, so I'm not sure if I want to buy this bootleg version of it. Again, maybe if my supplier gonna sell it on the cheap, then yeah, I'll consider getting it, then I'll make a comparison. But as of now, I'm saying this, I do not own the Bandai Freedom 2.0 as well as this Bandai RX 782 3.0 version. So yeah, but still expect it, I will be buying that soon enough in the near future. So yeah, second news is done. Now let's move on to our very third news. So our very third news, we have this red frame Mars jacket. It is announced by Tapan and they have already shown us the prototype picture of it. And yeah, I mean, I'm not sure about you, but I am one of the Astray line fans of it, because of just pure awesomeness of the samurai sword that it have. But again, it doesn't get the love from Bandai, so they are of course limited release. There are only Sengoku, and then you have Sengoku Astray Red Frame, then you have the normal Red Frame. I think that's really it on the Master Grade line. Then the Soi Tapa decided to step in and, you know, release their own version. So yeah, based on this prototype picture, you guys can see, I think from in close, in if you look really close, there's one picture in the background that's running. If you show really close, you can see that it looks great, but if very far away, it's very hard to see. It looks kind of dull and weird in a way. So yeah, again, we still don't know how it looks like, but I've already placed my pre-order with my supplier. So yeah, within near future, once I get the of course the kit, then I'll do the unboxing as well as the review. So stay tuned to that. So our very news for today is this Tapan metal build version as well for the red frame. As you guys know, the normal red frame metal build version is basically normal red frame, and then Bandai released out the P Bandai version add-on for the metal build version red frame, and this is it, the bulky armor, where it is able to carry the large sword. And again, the price is really, it's really crazy, I mean, for the P Bandai add-on extras. However, now Tapan decide to release their own version. As you guys can see, running on the background the pictures, they are already like on the way there. They are already have the kit sort of ready, and just prototyping, more of like cleaning up the stuff. And then you can see the pictures that are coming up are the very huge samurai sword that is in the P Bandai add-on for the Astral Reframe. Again, looks based on their prototype, you guys can see looks great. And I would like to mention is that previous the mask jacket of the Red Frame is designed by another person, and this Red Frame Metal Build version is again designed yet another designer, which was in charge in the Zeta sort of like detailed version. And then you have the Double X as well as the add-on detailed version as well. And if I'm not mistaken, he was also in charge in the Strike Freedom Metal Build version. If you guys have it, he's the one of it to responsible for the designing for it. So again, this not much news, but they just show us like a sneak peek of it. So again, we don't really have much details yet. Don't know when it's ready to pre-order. But yeah, once it's ready, I will of course pre-order to my supplier. Again, this time around, this month alone, there's so many news about Red Frame, and I'm actually quite happy with it. Red Frame now is finally getting the love it deserves from other third party or bootleg company, I would say. So yeah, really happy for it. If you guys are happy as well, well, you guys can maybe wait for my review, as then you guys can see. So and yeah, you can see whether you decide to buy or not, since not everyone can afford P Bandai as like me. So yeah, I guess this time around that's it for news. There is, again, like I mentioned, there are no news from other parties except for Fire Dragon and Tapan. Dragon Momoko has been really quiet as well. I guess they are sorting out their company stuff. So yeah, I guess that's it for today's video. So if you guys have enjoyed this video, please do not forget to drop a like down below. As I know, then I know you guys really interested in what are the news that is announced in bootleg or third party companies, as well as figure announcement. So yeah, I guess that's really it for now. I hope you guys have a good day, and I see you guys soon in my other videos. And of course, please do not forget to subscribe down below, and while you are there, don't forget to drop a like, because there will be more videos like this, news videos, figure reviews, unboxings, and even Gunpla reviews. So yeah, that's it. Again, hope you guys have a good day, and I'll see you guys real soon in another video.